The universe might have popped into existence from an infinitely small point spontaneously and formed hundreds of billions of galaxies, which led to me sitting here filming a YouTube video in my room, and everyone's walking around like this is normal. Life is a miracle, guys.
G'day, guys. Welcome back. My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Sorry about my little hiatus there. I'd be disappearing. Apologies. But we're back. We're going to be making a whole bunch of videos this month. At least I'm going to try to. Before we jump into it, I've got another book suggestion for you. 2010, Odyssey 2. My favorite ever book series. In fact, I love it so much, I've got two of them. I don't know why you need two of the same book, but I do. Now all I need is the audiobook. We're better than Audible, so visit audible.com/DylanDance or text DylanDance to 500-500. Link is in the bio. Check out 2010. In the midst of all the holiday excitement, think about giving yourself the gift of an Audible membership. Now is the absolute best time to do it with a special offer of 60% off your first 3 months. Everybody knows that Audible is the best spoken word entertainment provider on the planet, but did you know that they actually have more than just audiobooks? They've got podcasts, guided sleep tracks, fitness, all sorts of stuff. As an Audible member, you get one credit every month, good for any title in their entire premium selection. Those titles are yours to keep forever in your Audible library. You also keep those credits forever, and with an Audible membership, you also keep those titles forever, and you can download, listen to them offline on their app on smartphones. Audible's app is free and can be installed on all smartphones and tablets. New members can actually also try Audible for 30 days on them. Right now, for a limited time, save 60% on your first 3 months of Audible. That's only $5.95 a month. Give yourself the gift of listening. Thanks again to Audible. Visit audible.com/DylanDance or text DylanDance to 500-500. Let's get back into the video. Apologies if you can hear a fly buzzing around. He is coming with us on this journey to the end of the universe. So let's get started. Let's get straight into it. Let's go. What does our future hold? Not too much. Everything has its wonders, even darkness and silence. It's true, deep you look into things, you realize almost everything is interesting. What does the future look like? How will the universe meet its end? It's pretty bleak. We may never be truly certain. That's a great thing to put at the start, but science has begun to paint a stunning picture of how the future might unfold. Emphasis on the might. Let's take a journey to the end of time. We will travel through time exponentially, doubling our speed every 5 seconds. Okay, this vision of the future will surely evolve as we probe for more clues. But one thing is clear, the universe has only just begun. It certainly has only just begun. Oh, my boy David Attenborough.
What we do now, and in the next few years, will profoundly affect the next few thousand years.
I saw a Mars colony. Wow. Deadly gamma ray burst. Yeah, we think possibly one of the mass extinction events was caused by a gamma ray burst. Saturn's rings vanish. That's actually probably going to happen sooner. They're rapidly disappearing. Major asteroid impact. Boom. That as well could happen tomorrow. You might think NASA monitors a lot of the sky, and they do. They try their best. But there's some stuff that hides in the sun. You can't exactly see it if it's coming directly in the sunlight. So miss things until they've already passed us or they're just about to pass us. So don't be surprised if you wake up tomorrow and there's a, you know, giant about to hit our planet. It's a possibility. New supercontinent. Sun increases luminosity. Oh, Brian Cox. So yeah, this sun. Our sun is going to expand, slowly getting hotter. What year are we up to? 710,000? Yep, because in about a billion years, the oceans are going to evaporate. And unless we figured out how to get off this planet, if we're still around, I highly doubt it. But fade away to nothing. All plant life dies.
Its core will collapse. And oceans evaporate. The extra heat this generates will cause its outer layers to expand.
It's a red giant. And it goes nova, sorry, and the outer layers explode in a planetary nebula. That's what they called it. It's a bit.
The sun, you know, is now
it's
dead.
A bad name.
It remains slowly cooling in the freezing temperatures of deep space.
50 billion years already. Okay. What are we? 3.5 minutes in? 25 minutes to go?
The fate of the sun is the same as for all stars. One day, They must all eventually die, and the cosmos will be plunged into eternal night.
Okay, we're almost at a trillion years.
Eventually, we'll run out of fuel. The temperature of the universe...
So, the white dwarfs, they're actually going to turn into black dwarfs. The universe isn't even old enough yet for any of these black dwarfs to even exist. We're at 2 trillion years, and everything's dead. And we've got 25 minutes to go. Why are we here? Just to suffer?
And there'll be no more new stars created. And so that the universe will end not with a bang, but with a whimper. And not in fire, but in ice.
With the death of the last sun, the age of starlight comes to an end. A billion trillion years, neutron stars collide. We get lots of cool stuff out of one of those collisions, like gold, we think at least. I think I read a paper, and we think a lot of the gold in the universe actually might have come from these merging of neutron stars, which is really cool. Any surviving life forms may find refuge around aging white dwarfs. Yes. The music is sensational. When the screen goes black and you just see how ugly you are. Trillion years.
A dark, dense, decaying balls of degenerate matter.
Bit like me.
More than the ashes of stars. Their constituent atoms are so severely crushed that black dwarfs are a million times denser than our sun.
That is a didgeridoo. That's some aborigine music. I love that. Stars become black dwarfs.
Stars take so long to reach this point. We believe there are currently no black dwarfs in the universe.
That's what I said before. I hope this puts some things into perspective for you guys. Gives you a bit of cosmic humility. Nothing like a good existential crisis to make you realize that piece of homework doesn't matter. Oh, here we go. As the expansion of the universe accelerates, it begins to spread matter apart faster than the speed of light. That's already happening. Billion, trillion, trillion years. So I think his time scales are a bit off. That's going to happen well before that. You're talking like 100 trillion years. Things are going to be pretty much over. By this point, distant galaxy, the stars are receding so fast that their light has become undetectable. That's not that far away. The secrets of the cosmos are locked away forever. Yep. I should say, though, that these, you know, distant... Current theories predict that atoms themselves will begin to decay, destroying all remaining matter in the universe. That's true. Protons have a half-life.
A proton.
It's a very long time.
The fundamental building blocks of atomic matter, what makes us up, can just spontaneously fall apart.
Any material that evades the pull of a black hole eventually dies away as its protons disintegrate.
Proton decay is still unproven, so this chapter of the future could look very different in the light of Newton. I don't like him saying that because a lot of this is unproven. Like, why hasn't he said that for everything? We're a long way into the future now. Proton decay?
The matter inside black dwarfs, the last matter in the universe, will eventually evaporate away and be carried off into the void as radiation, leaving absolutely nothing behind.
That's just not true, Brian Cox. You've still got dark matter. We don't know what that even is, but it has mass, and because we see its interaction through gravity, so it'll probably still be around. So there'll still be a lot in the universe.
With the black dwarves gone, there won't be a single atom of matter left.
like I just said, it's possibly dark matter is possibly made of atoms.
Will be particles of light and black holes.
The black hole era begins. It should really be called depression. No planets, no stars, no lingering stellar remnants for life to cling to. Yet even now, time has only just begun to tick. Our universe gives life only a brief moment to shine, a haven in time, safe from its fiery birth and icy death. Again, how do we know that? Like, life might come in many different forms. We've got one sample size of one. We can't really speculate as to what life really can be like. And it's, you know, look how creative the universe is and what's going on. Every time we make these discoveries, it's usually beyond what we even imagined. So to think that there's not more unimaginable things happening in the universe is, I think, a lack of, understanding of history and how we've come to know what we know. It's a lot of cosmic humility. He did mention that black holes will evaporate, so that is coming.
Filled with black holes continue to evolve.
So cool.
They'll eat each other and they'll get bigger, and maybe they'll fall into the supermassive black hole and it'll get bigger. The universe will still be an exciting, dynamic place. It's just that the timescales you're talking about are now trillions of years instead of...
Scientists used to think black holes were immortal, but even these will one day die.
Now we're talking timescales of unimaginable length, quadrillions of years into the future. On that time scale, even the black holes begin to evaporate.
Black holes begin to die. I love the waltz. It's very fitting.
So what will be the future of the universe? Well, if the dark energy remains dominant and repulsive...
If. Big if.
The universe will expand forever.
And this comes down to, the universe is called the end of time or whatever. And he just said it will expand forever. Well, what is time?
The universe resides in empty space, and we don't understand why. But we do know what will happen. If that energy continues to be there, the universe will become cold and dark and empty. That's the future as it might be. We don't know.
That's why he's my boy. Might be.
We don't understand the nature of dark energy. Until we do, we won't know the future. We won't even understand our own origins.
This should have been emphasized at the start.
Study this subject.
Discovering the true nature of dark energy could change our vision of the future dramatically. Yes. Like, dramatically, dramatically. If it somehow weakens over time, the universe could collapse under gravity in a big crunch, yes.
After an unimaginable length of time, even the black holes will have evaporated, and the universe will be nothing but a sea of photons gradually tending towards the same temperature as the expansion of the universe cools them towards absolute zero.
You still might have some quantum fields there. So they, like we were saying earlier, cause virtual particles to pop in and out of existence. So that's how the universe could seemingly come from nothing once again. You know, these random quantum fluctuations that cause some inflationary event. And then a big bang and voila. We're sitting in our rooms making YouTube videos. Everything has its wonders, even darkness and silence. And I learn, whatever state I may be in, therein to be content. That is a beautiful message. Yeah. Make sure you guys stay in the present and enjoy whatever the hell this is, because it's pretty... It's clearly a miracle. So I think we should end the video there. And I hope you guys, you know, look at this positively rather than in a depressing light. I hope it gives you an existential crisis, though, and wakes you up to what is going on in this universe. Life is, whatever we're doing right now and walking around, it's not normal. So make sure you think about, dwell on this stuff. And I think you should dwell on it often because it allows you to appreciate things better. You know, having a bit of cosmic humility really brings what's important into focus. But just enjoy whatever this is, and I'll catch you guys next time in whatever this is.